So far, we've registered the Plone personal bar viewlet for the footer, put it in the place we want relative to other viewlets, and hidden it in the portal top. Now, let's say that we want to add another viewlet to the footer. How do we do that? As before, the first thing we need to do is to register our new viewlet using the Configure ZCML in our product's browser folder. As before, in the registration, we need to give our viewlet a name. In this case, because it's our own custom viewlet, we can call it what we like. I'm going to give it the name of my theme and then the word custom so that I know it's my custom viewlet. We need to specify the manager for the viewlet. Again, I'm going to use the footer, so I specify the interface for the footer here. I only want this viewlet to be visible when my theme product is installed, so as before, I make sure that I include a layer that's specific to my theme product. I set the same permission on it as Plone has on its personal bar viewlet. And this is a new thing. I'm going to specify a template, which is where the code for the viewlet will live. So let's go and make that file, viewlet.pt. Here I have some text, which I would like my custom viewlet to contain. Again, as before, if we want our new viewlet to appear in a specific order relative to other viewlets in the same viewlet manager, we need to alter viewlets.xml. Here, I'm going to insert our custom viewlet after the footer. Because we change configure.zcml, we have to stop Zope and restart it. And because we changed viewlets.xml, we have to uninstall our theme and then reinstall it. Now, when we refresh our site, we can see that our new viewlet is incorporated. It's worth noting here that our instructions about exactly where to insert this new viewlet relative to other viewlets seem to have gone a little awry. I find this is fairly common with viewlets.xml, and the only really reliable way to make the viewlets appear in the order which you want, if you're inserting more than one or two viewlets, is to, in viewlets.xml, specify the viewlets in exactly which order you want. So here we're going to have Plone personal bar Plone footer, custom viewlet, and then our colophon. We're also going to remove all these instructions about inserting before and inserting after. We save that, uninstall and reinstall our product. We refresh our page, and the viewlets are in the order in which we want them. In case you were wondering why the custom viewlet appears red, it's because I added some CSS to my product to make this custom viewlet stand out for now. Thus far, our custom viewlet has been very simple. We simply wanted some static text in the viewlet. Therefore, in our configure ZCML file, we were able to point the viewlet registration directly at the template. However, if you want to do something slightly more complicated with your template, you can't point the viewlet registration at the template directly. Instead, what you need to do is to point the viewlet registration at a Python class, which in turn points at a custom template. We're going to do that now. I'm going to register my custom viewlet rather than pointing it directly at a template. I'm going to point it at a class. So I change my configure ZCML to, instead of pointing at a template, point at a Python class. I'm going to put that Python class in the viewlets.py file in my product's browser folder. Again, I could put it anywhere. I happen to use this file partly because Paster gives me a file ready for me to use, and partly because the name viewlets.py is readily comprehensible to other people. It suggests that it contains Python code relating to viewlets. Why do we need to point the viewlet registration at a Python class? Well, it's because we want the viewlet to display something that, unless we used a Python class to define it, the viewlet would have no idea what this thing was. For example, let's imagine that we want our viewlet to show today's date and time. This is a very simple example, but it serves to show the principle. We need to write our Python class to compute the things we want to display in the template, as we've done here, and then we need to amend the template to call these things in. So here, I'm going to add some code to this template that calls in the value that we computed using that Python class. Because we changed a Python class, we need to stop and start Zope before we continue. When we refresh, we see that our custom code has indeed been incorporated in our custom viewlet. In the last part of this screencast, I'd like to discuss uninstall profiles. Let me just uninstall my theme product in which I made my viewlet customizations. Go back to my site, refresh, and oh dear. I hope you can see that even though I've uninstalled the product and some elements of the theme are gone, for example the colours have gone back to Plone's defaults, the changes that I made to viewlets have not disappeared. The personal bar viewlet is still absent from the portal top, it's in the footer, and for some reason we can still see our own custom viewlet. What's more, if you go to the ZMI and to portal skins, click on the Properties tab, you'll see that some elements of our skin have been left behind, even though we have apparently uninstalled it. To clean up portal skins properly, and to remove our viewlets properly, we need to explicitly write an uninstall profile. To do that, we need to go to the same place in which the install profile is specified. In my theme product, this is in a file called profile.zcml. In yours, it might be in the same file, or it might be in an overall configure.zcml file. The profile.zcml file already contains a registration profile for what happens on install. We need to add one for what happens on uninstall. The format is very much the same. We just need to point this uninstall profile at a new folder which we're going to add in our product. Into this folder, we add two files. This viewlets.xml file will hold the uninstall configuration for the viewlet managers, which we affected through our install configuration. The second file we add in here is going to be a skins.xml file, and in that, we're going to set the skins folder back the way we found it, in this case, back to Plone default. So we've told generic setup that this profile exists, and we've pointed it at a particular set of files in a particular folder. The next thing is to tell Plone when to run the uninstall profile. Depending on which version of Plone you're using, that may be all you need to do. But if you're using a version of Plone where this isn't enough, and you'll know because you try to uninstall and reinstall your product and you will not notice anything happen, you'll need to do an extra step. Create another folder called Extensions with a capital E at the same level as the Browser and Skins folder. And in that, add a Python script called install.py. Into this file you just added, add some code that will tell Plone when to run the install profile and when to run the uninstall profile. We've added some files, we've changed a Python script and some ZCML, so before we can see our changes, we need to stop and restart Zope. We then install our theme and uninstall it. Now, when we look at our site with the theme uninstalled, we should see everything set back to the way that it was before we installed our theme in the first place. And there we have it. We've created a theme product which, when installed, removes a viewlet from where Plone put it and instead puts it in a different viewlet manager and inserts a custom viewlet of our own. When uninstalled, this product puts the site back to the Plone default theme.